So in this video presentation, we're going to look at the three-phase safe isolation procedure. In the classroom, before starting this exercise, we have discussed things like permits to work, signs and barriers, and other procedures that need to be considered before the safe isolation process begins. We want to carry out the safe isolation in the safest possible manner. So it means we won't be going in and just throwing the main switch here. And in this case, we also have a remote switch. So this switch here will also isolate this distribution board. We have other switches around the workshop that also can be used for isolating the distribution board. So we're going to work in the safest possible manner. Exactly the same as we did with a single phase consumer unit. We're going to isolate individual circuits first. So we end up turning off the main switches with no current being drawn, or hopefully no current being drawn. So what we don't want to do is start throwing this switch with all the circuits currently energized. So let's go about that next. So we're going to turn off individual circuit breakers, reducing the current down that the main switch will obviously isolate, expecting it to be zero. So we've turned off all of the devices within the distribution board. We next throw the main switch, which can be tricky. Okay, and we've thrown that offload, so there's no current going through it. And as we have a remote switch away from the consumer unit, or distribution board in this case, we can turn that one off as well. That's the one we're going to secure the isolation process on. And this is the position where we will lock it off and put our sign before entering the distribution board in order to prove the circuit is dead. So let's lock off our isolator here before entering this electrical enclosure. Remember, we should have been looking for signs of things going off. So as I was turning off individual circuit breakers, we should have been noticing maybe lights, sockets, machines, etc. going off. So when we do enter the electrical enclosure, we are considering it to be isolated, but working in a manner that suggests that if it was live, that we're still working safely, especially when we're thinking about metallic enclosures being removed. So care still needs to be taken when removing the covers, but we're in a position where we think it's been isolated safely. So as we have a remote means of isolation for our distribution board, this is the point in which we're going to secure the isolation. Padlock, key and sign. I'm not going to use the master lock this time. So I'm just going to position that through there like so, take my sign, position it like so, and lock it off. Super duper important that you keep the key. Do not place it on the top, put it into your pocket. If you leave it behind where the assessor can get hold of it, you will fail either AM2 or AM2S, so keep the key. So I'm now in a position where I can remove the front of this distribution board. I believe I've isolated it correctly, but I'm still going in with care and caution. Okay, I'm gonna remove the four screws. In this case, I can take the door off this style, so I'm gonna take the door off to make it easier. I'm going to remove the front four screws and then I'm in there. Care when taking it off to remove it. And we're now looking at where we're going to actually prove that this distribution board has been isolated.